Kim's class voted on a location for a field trip. One third of the class voted for the science museum. One sixth of the class voted for the water park. The rest of the class voted for the zoo. What fraction of the class voted for the zoo? You can see that right away I've put my important information down from this problem. Again, don't get lost on the details of the word problem that don't matter. The names, things like that. I went ahead and made myself just a little cheat sheet, and now I think I'd like to draw a picture. So I really like to represent fraction problems with rectangles. So I'm going to draw a rectangle, and this represents the whole class. And even though I may not be able to perfectly draw these right now, at least it will give me a visual of what operation I need to use, because that's probably the trickiest part of this problem. So I know that a third of the class wanted the science museum. So this one third wanted the science museum. I know that one sixth of the class wanted the water park. Okay, so let's just say that's about a sixth. Again, it's not important that you're perfectly drawing these or perfectly separating your rectangle. What's more important is that you are getting an idea of what operation you need to use. The rest of this wanted the zoo. So the rest of the class wanted the zoo, but I'm not totally sure what fraction that is right now. Okay, I know that if I were to, let's say, add this part and this part together, that I could subtract that from the whole class and then solve for this zoo. So that's exactly what I want to do. So first I'm going to add one third and one sixth together. Now let me just give a caveat here. You could take the whole and start subtracting away. That would also work. And remember, when I say the whole, I'm literally just talking about one. One is the whole in this case. So you could take one and subtract one third, and then from that number subtract one sixth. So in essence, you would be doing 1 minus 1 third minus 1 sixth. I think that the easier thing in this case is to add my two fractions together and then subtract them from the whole. So that's what I'm going to do. So I have 1 third plus 1 sixth. And I know that when I add fractions, I have to have common denominators. I have to be comparing and combining fractions that have the same number of pieces. So I know that 6 is a multiple of 3, so I'm going to multiply the top and the bottom by 2 over 2. Now, why are you allowed to just multiply this fraction by any number? Well, because when you multiply it by the same number on the top and the bottom, you're really multiplying it by 1. You didn't change it any. So we're, in essence, just cutting those pieces into smaller pieces. So 1 times 2 is 2. 3 times 2 is 6. So now I have 2 sixths plus 1 sixth. I can keep my denominators the same because I know that I'm adding copies of a 6 right now. 2 plus 1 is 3. So I have 3 sixths. I can go ahead and reduce this. I know that I can divide both of these by 3 and get 1 half. That is an option. You don't have to do that, though, in order to subtract it from a whole. However, when I reduce it, this one makes it actually quite nice to then subtract from. So I have 1 over 1 minus 1 half. Again, I can get common denominators. So I'm going to get 2 over 2 minus 1 half, which is going to give me 1 half. And if you think about that, a whole candy bar, you break it in half and take away half, you still have a half left. So what fraction of the class voted for the zoo? 1 half. I hope you found this video helpful and less overwhelming for this problem. Have a great day.